me.
I was definitely rambunctious. You know, I'm the youngest of three boys, and I was this athlete that was just always on the go. I was just playing every sport under the sun. And so I was definitely like a happy-go-lucky kid that just sort of was full of life.
There's my brother again. Where's Zach?
And I grew up in like a really great home. I had great brothers, great parents. I really had a pretty idyllic childhood.
There's Dad, here's Captain Zach.
And here's me close up.
I remember it was a really special feeling. All three of us were at McCallie at the same time. So I was in sixth grade, middle brother was in eighth grade, oldest brother was in 12th grade. It was a special time, man. That was a really special time for me. My folks are both from Florida, so we would always go to Florida like right before school started. I was scuba diving 7 miles off the coast of the Keys, and I got pushed behind the boat, and my mom thought that the boat might come down on my head, which there was a real threat of that. That was the clearest threat to us. So she, you know, tried to get out of the way real quick and gun the boat, and the propeller pulled me in, and I knew immediately it was just a freak accident. I knew my legs were gone. So I was obviously lucky to survive that. It was a really, really bad injury. I was airlifted to Miami. I was in the hospital for 10 days, underwent 3 surgeries, and who shows up there in the hospital? McCallie guys. McCallie sent stuff. Remember it clear as day, like these arms, it was like a paper thing they cut out that was huge that all the middle school kids signed. And like that was in my hospital room, you know, like right there. I was lucky enough to fly back to Chattanooga. As I land on the tarmac, who's there? Kenny Scholl, Jim Mankey, the golf team, McCallie men are there. That was really special for me and was a huge part of how I got through it, was like the community. I remember 3 days after I'd been home, McCallie was playing that night and I went to the football game. And I remember sitting on the track in my wheelchair surrounded by McCallie men, and there's like a standing ovation in Spear Stadium, because that's what McCallie is. It's community and it's connection and it's support, and it's what we do is if somebody needs support and help, you act. And that's like what McCallie is. And I know that because I lived that. And I've been fortunate enough now to pay that forward. And so it's this symbiotic thing where you just like build people up and support.
At only age 16, with his family's help, he started the Jordan Thomas Foundation, helping disadvantaged kids.
5 days after I've lost my legs, I started a foundation for kids that couldn't afford prosthetics. As I'm still getting my bandages changed, fresh off like this extremely traumatic event, when I learned about the reality that kids face with prosthetics, my first instinct was how I need to be part of the solution here. The only way a 16-year-old does that is it's been developed in them. And that's born out of McCallie, period. The name is the Jordan Thomas Foundation, and we provide prosthetic devices to kids until they reach adulthood. I was an able-bodied kid going about my life, so I'd never been confronted with prosthetics until 2005. When I learned that kids outgrow their prosthetics once a year, maybe a year and a half, I mean, think of it like shoes for kids. A 10-year-old can't wear the same shoes he's gonna wear in a year and a half because they're growing so quickly. Same for prosthetics, and insurance companies deny access regularly to devices. They say it's not medically necessary. And we're working on some mentorship programs so that families that have been through trauma or limb loss can connect with families that have been on that path before. We're really trying our best to create sort of a holistic approach to taking care of young amputees, both here in the States and globally.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in honoring CNN hero Jordan Thomas.
A big thing for me is to be really real and authentic about the darkness sometimes. I think a lot of people see my story and a lot of people think like, wow, that's so admirable. What a hero, like the courage. And I think those things are true. And I think they're not mutually exclusive. I think they're inclusive because it's the story. But there were times where some days I didn't have the courage to just get up. I didn't have the resources and the tools emotionally at the time as a 16-year-old boy to deal with that level of trauma and grief and sorrow. At certain times in my life, I felt sad, I felt anxious, and I convinced myself that it would be that way forever, and that's just not true. But when I asked for help, and I said, hey man, I'm really struggling, they come out of the woodwork. McCallie men came out of the woodwork. My family came out of the woodwork. Golf community came out of the woodwork. Everybody from all facets of my life. When I just had the courage to say, hey man, I'm struggling. I'm hurting. It is not always darkness. Like, there is light.
He was invited to the inaugural U.S. Adaptive Open last week and placed fifth overall.
You see what each of us now that have left the ridge, what we're doing in our own respective lives, that was born at McCallie. Like, that was instilled in us at McCallie on the ridge. Honor, truth, and duty is not a figure of speech or some abstract concept. It's the real deal. Man's chief end is to glorify God and to enjoy him forever. Like, I live that. And a lot of my classmates live that.
It took a serious accident like mine to realize the value in helping the fellow man. My biggest hope is that it doesn't take an accident like mine for everyone to realize the joy of helping those in need. Thank you so much for bestowing me with this incredible honor. This has been the greatest night of my life. So thank you very much.
A young man's personal battle now for healthcare dollars illustrates the issue on Capitol Hill that is playing out even as we speak. Jordan Thomas lost his legs.
We really have ambitious goals to change legislation. I think by passing common sense policy that holds insurance companies accountable, you create long-term sustained change there. So at the end of the day, the goal of any, I think, organization is to put yourself out of business. Like, there's no reason why my foundation should exist. And that's what I want to do.